Hello everyone, this is Jin, a TCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. Here is my online class for Pathology. This class specially for TCM students. The book we used I put below here. I can help the students to study and review for the class. Okay, let's start.
Then we talk about another heart illness. So heart rate changing. We know normally heart rate will be regularly. Regular rate and regular like the space, like each beating space is regularly. That keep your heart working normally and sending blood go to all over the body. So heart rate control, they have a special conduction systems like we learned in our physiology class. So basically they have a SA nose. It's located on the right side of the heart, basically in the aorta area, artery area. So that SA nose, we say in the right side artery and close the supravena. Yeah, close supravena. So that's the name coming from. Yeah. SA. That's the melee. Yeah, that's the melee or heart rate coming. We also call it pacemaker. And we have another nose we call AV nose. Yeah, AV nose. So AV nose located on the right side of the atrium. So that's, we say AV nose. But AV nose receive the information coming from the SA nose. AV nose not make the read itself. They just receive the, like the signal from the SA nose. So SA nose is more important for controlled heart rate. So like how faster to beat you, how slow, and how regularly. And certainly we have some nerve bunches. It's separate bunches with nerve systems, but the same idea like electrical signal transmissions go to both sides of the heart. So just pay attention here. When we talk about SA nose connected with AV nose. They have few bunches go to there. And the same time, they have bunches send the information go to both sides of the artery, yeah, both sides of the artery. It will be caused both sides of the artery contraction, same time. Then the information sending to AV nose, from the AV nose sending the impulse go to both sides of the heart, like a ventricle part. So basically ventricle part, heart muscle contraction same time. So that's basically we have a time space from atrium contraction to ventricle contraction. So that's exactly the time the blood flow from the atrial to the ventricle first, and the ventricle contraction pushing the blood coming out. So that's basically normally happens. And keep the normal rate and the regular rate. That's the pretty important part for heart bump the blood all over the body regularly and have enough amount. But for some reasons, some illness, or some chemicals, getting some changing, structure of changing for the normal heart, then they may cause heart rate changing. Sometimes heart rate is decreased, sometimes it's increased, especially we're talking about the irregular rate. So that causes a lot of problems. Many problems. Like last page, we talk about the heart, like they sending blood from atrium to the ventricle, and then ventricle sending blood coming out. Like a small space they sending, and then the heart jumping is not enough blood to push it out. And maybe too long, is like holding the blood in the heart. So both of like irregular rate or maybe too fast or too slow is caused problems like not enough blood sending all over the body and not enough oxygen sending all over the body. So heart rate problems could be very severe, could be not that severe. Is depending, like it occasionally happens, or maybe always happens, and also depending, like is totally irregular, or maybe some regular space in there. So, but generally say, it is a heart issue caused all our body's issues. So basically, irregular heart rate, certainly when we feel the pulse, sometimes we can feel it. Yeah, we can feel it. If we heard the sound coming from the heart, we can hear it. Yeah, we can hear it, we can feel it. But typically go to diagnosis or check, ECG is the machine, specially recorder for the electrical changing happens in the heart. And from ECG report, we can identify different reason cause the irregular heart rate. We say mainly reason is SA nose problems, but truly possible have other reasons, like transmission the signal from the SA nose to AV nose, or maybe transmission from the AV nose to the branch to the blood vessels. So truly, that's a clear diagnosis. We need the ECG to help. But a severe kind of irregular heart rate, we can feel it. Like some people talking about the missing heartbeat, that's belong to like an irregular heart rate problems. So that's for today, for today's class. Today's class, we're talking about heart diseases, yeah. So we say our pathology, we're talking about illness. Today, we're especially talking about illness happens in the heart. Heart illness, we have a lot of different kind, yeah. We just pick up four big category is more commonly happens. We're talking about certainly not limited, only have these four. We will have more. Like sometimes virus infections and cause heart muscles inflammation, yeah, something like that. But we did pick up four pretty common ones, pretty common ones. The first one we're talking about heart failure. Yeah. Heart failure means heart not enough stronger to pushing the blood go to blood circulation. We separate with left side heart failure and the right side of heart failure. And the congenital kind of heart disorder, that means the baby just after birthing, they will have heart issue. So normally we say heart is separate their blood circulation, left side and the right side. But for these kind of patients, they some part is not closed. They have some past root, like a heart can communicate the left side, right side. Blood can flowing from left side to right side mainly. Certainly sometimes possible both. Left side to right side to left side. So that's still cause the patient's issue. And the third one is especially talking about blood flowing to the heart. Yeah, blood flowing to the heart. For some reason, it's blocked. It's like just partly blocking there. And the patient have chest pain kind of symptoms. We call it angina. It's totally blocking and cause severe kind of issue. We call the heart attacking. And later on, we talking about heart rate have some problems. Mainly, we are not especially talking about too low or too fast. Mainly, we talking about irregular heart rate. Yeah. Irregular heart rate can cause by different reasons, and they have a lot of different patterns. We didn't talk about that too detail, but generally we say irregular heart rate can cause the people maybe severe, very, very severe kind of problems. Maybe people maybe just don't feel it. Like usually we talk about if some people missing heart rate less than 5 times a minute. Yeah, less than 5 times a minute. We're still thinking about that normal kind of condition. So we say that's still possible, normal, still possible, normal. Certainly we need to go to other check to make sure people have no other issues. And especially checking about heart, we have special machine we call ECG. Certainly we have more tracking about the basic one. Yeah. So that's about heart issue. Yeah, that's about heart issue about today's class. Any questions?